All right, ninja nerds, we're going to take a look here at the male pelvis. So if we look here, we got a couple muscles here that I want to first look at. This one right here, so it's called the bulbospongiosus muscle. So the bulbospongiosus muscle, it actually can contract at about 11 miles an hour to blast sperm out. This guy right here is the ischiocavernosus. This right here is the ischiocavernosus right there also. And then this muscle right here is actually going to be called the superficial transverse perineus. And then this one over here on that side is the superficial transverse perineus here too. And all of these muscles that I mentioned, the superficial, transverse perineus, the ischiocavernosus, and the bulbospongiosus, they all help to be able to maintain the erection of the clitoris and the penis. So that's their function right there. Then if we come over here in the back, we got this sphincter muscle right here. This sphincter muscle is called the external anal sphincter. And so it's controlled by your somatic nervous system. So whenever you find it appropriate, you can voluntarily relax this muscle and evacuate the bowels, right? Now, sometimes you need a little help from some of these muscles right back here. And this is called the levator ani. And then you can also see another piece of levator ani over here. The levator ani is actually divided into two types of muscles, like two different parts of it. You got the pubococcygeus and then you have the iliococcygeus. And they have the coccygeus back here too. So here's the coccygeus right here also. So coccygeus right here and coccygeus right there. And all of these muscles that I just mentioned, the levator ani and the coccygeus, these guys are responsible for being able to fight gravity and to support the pelvic contents. But another thing that the levator ani can do is it can actually elevate the anal canal to help to lift the anal canal to expel the feces also. So that's another function of it too. And again, just remember that the levator ani, it has two muscle parts of it, pubococcygeus and iliococcygeus. So quick recap again, bulbospongiosus muscle right here, ischiocavernosus, superficial transverse perineus, external anal sphincter, levator ani with the two branches, the pubococcygeus and the iliococcygeus, and then the coccygeus. And again, one other thing I wanted to mention is you can't see in this model, you can't see the internal anal sphincter. It would be an inner lining here of smooth muscle. And you can't see the external urethral sphincter. It would be right around the membranous urethra. All right, so that gives us everything we need to know about this male pelvis. All right, guys, we're going to take a look here at the female pelvis. So again, this is, if you guys look here, this is going to be the bulbospongiosus right there. And this is the bulbospongiosus right there. This muscle right here coming down, this is the ischiocavernosus, and then this is the ischiocavernosus right there, and then this is the superficial transverse perineus, and you can also see the superficial transverse perineus right there. And again, all of these guys help to be able to maintain the erection of the clitoris and the penis. All right, and then if you look here, this is, you can't see it, but there is a, inside here, there is going to be a internal urethral sphincter, you just can't see that one. And then you can't see the external urethral sphincter in this one either. It doesn't show it on this one. If you look here, this is going to be same thing, external anal sphincter right there. So that's the external anal sphincter. And then if we come back here, this is again levator ani with the pubococcygeus and the iliococcygeus. And then again back here is going to be the coccygeus back here. So coccygeus, and then we're over here, coccygeus right there.